Okay, good evening, everybody. This is Team RL, and this is Rajdeep speaking. Once again, I'll just reiterate that we are in a program where we are giving our interns an opportunity to speak on a topic. Could be a topic of law, could be a topic of interest, could be of national interest. And today we have Khushi, who will be speaking on a very intriguing, interesting, and a very important topic, which is the interpretation of Regulation 23. 1C of the Takeover Code 2011. Over to you, Khushi.
Thank you, sir. Sir, can I get the permission to share my screen?
Done.
Hello everybody, am I audible? And is my screen visible?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So today I'm going to speak about the topic Regulation 23-1C, a pathway to waiver of obligation. I'm going to first give a brief introduction regarding what I will speak in the next 10 minutes. Without further ado, let's begin. So, the Takeover Regulation Advisory Committee, that is TRAC, under C. Achuthan, deliberated that Regulation 23-1 of the SEBI Takeover Code 2011 set forth the circumstances under which the open offer made would be subjected to legitimate withdrawal. And these circumstances include impossibility and non-attainment of any conditions stipulated in the agreement for reasons beyond the control of the acquirer. Notably, Regulation 23-1C permits the withdrawal in the case of failure to meet stipulated conditions other than minimum level of acceptance, such as MAC, which I will explain later, where such failure is subjected to reasons beyond the control of the acquirer. I'm going to specifically interpret Regulation 23-1C in the light of non-applicability of the doctrine of exiguum generis on stipulated conditions, such as MAC, while referring the frustration of purpose as a canon for withdrawal of the offer. I will also analyze on the scope of MAC clause under the ambit of Regulation 23-1C. Moving on to the non-applicability of exiguum generis on Regulation 23-1C. Now, what is exiguum generis doctrine? It means of the same kind. Example, if a law refers automobiles, trucks, and other motor-powered vehicles, court might use exiguum generis to hold that such vehicles would not include airplanes because the list included only land-based transportation. The application of exiguum generis to interpret the impugned regulation would defy its purpose as there is no common genus between these clauses. TRAC explained that a clause relating to the death of the acquirer and the statutory approval forms the genus of impossibility, whereas the withdrawal upon the failure of the stipulated conditions stands would be applied to distinct. TRAC examined the regulation in other jurisdictions and found that in certain jurisdictions such as UK and US, the acquirers are allowed to withdraw an open offer if the conditions specified in the offer are not met, and deliberated that whether non-attainment of conditions other than regulatory approvals should be permitted as reason for withdrawal of the offer. Impossibility is a higher standard as compared to stipulated conditions such as MAC. For example, the existence of MAC may cause adverse civil consequences. However, it does not mean that the performance of such transaction is rendered impossible. Therefore, Regulation 23-1C is not confined to the ground of impossibility. Moving on to the frustration of purpose as a canon for withdrawal. Now, open offer is considered sacrosanct except in circumstances mentioned under Regulation 23-1, where withdrawal of an open offer must be allowed. The objective of the Regulation 23-1C is to safeguard the interest of the shareholders as well as the sense of the offer. In the case of Messrs. Jyoti Limited versus SEBI, it was observed that the provisions of Regulation 23-1 is similar to the provisions of Regulation 27-1 of the old Takeover Code and rejected the plea of the withdrawal of an open offer based on non-impossibility. However, the interpretation of Regulation 23-1C is not limited to the mere impossibility of performing the condition, but it also includes frustration of purpose. In municipal corporation, it was held that the intent of the legislature and the construction which subserves the purpose of the enactment must be adopted. The legislative intent can be gauged from the insertion of the term beyond the reasonable control of the acquirer, which reflects that it does not fall within the genus of impossibility. Further, applying only the impossibility criteria to the interpretation of Regulation 23(1)(c), which is based on the concept of conditional requirements for the fulfillment of open offer, would prove contrary to the essence of the concept of conditional offer under Regulation 19(1), where the offer is conditional upon minimum level of acceptance. Thereby, any adverse change which leads to frustration of purpose of an open offer should also form a ground for withdrawal. Moving on to the legal derivation on material adverse change clause. MAC refers to any material change in the business, results of operations, assets, liabilities, or financial conditions of the target company and its subsidiaries, as determined outside the reasonable control of the acquirer. This definition is exclusive of any specific events, namely an act of God, terrorism, economic recession, market failure, pandemic such as COVID-19, or any health emergency. Drawing interface between MAC clause and Regulation 23(1)(c), MAC shall be interpreted as conditions stipulated in the agreement, which is beyond the control of the acquirer, to validate withdrawal under Regulation 23(1)(c). Therefore, if acquirer includes conditions such as MAC clause in the agreement, where non-fulfillment of such conditions will allow merit withdrawal of the open offer. The acquirer cannot trigger MAC clause based on the circumstances he was aware at the time of agreement. Similarly, in the case of Grupo, the court interpreted the MAC clause depending upon the terms of the clause construed under the well-established principle and ruled that when the financial conditions of the company does not prove any material change, then MAC clause should not be invoked. Regulation 23(1)(c) made it possible to withdraw an open offer without confining to the grounds impossibility. In Luxottica, the SAT held, stated that reasonable conditions may be put in offer document and difficulty in fulfilling these conditions may be grounds for withdrawal. In other jurisdictions like Singapore and UK, MAC clause is also determined objectively and have not only left to subjective determination by the acquirer. They also have determination for the sanctity of an offer and allow withdrawal in failure of the MAC clause, which disturbs the core of the transaction. Moving on to the conclusion, notwithstanding the discrepancies and lack of insights, the Indian jurisdiction has not yet solved the dilemma regarding the applicability of doctrine of assumed generis, while further extending the dilemma under Regulation 23(1)(c) of the Takeover Code 2011, is silent on the insights of MAC clause, which is a burning point of concern in the foreign jurisdictions such as US and UK. The Delaware Supreme Court has found only once that a MAC occurred in the case of Econ and permitted termination of a merger agreement. Whereas in the Indian context, this discrepancy needs to be addressed to bring some level of congruity and certainty in takeover jurisprudence with respect to MAC clause. The MAC clause has a high check to the finding of material change so that the acquirer cannot commit frivolous offers which can lead to distress in the stock of target company. Hence, a balance must be created to the extent that SEBI is able to consider situations where, due to changes circumstances beyond the control of the acquirer, the open offers may be permitted to be withdrawn to protect the interests of the acquirer. Thank you.
Thank you so much. It was really very insightful with all the provisions that you've shown. Thank you all the attendees, the viewers for joining in today. Thank you so much.